houses or building houses. So, before I start the topic building houses, what is meant by building houses? What is the exact meaning of building houses? Houses, one of the most important thing in our life. It is said, roti, kapda, makan. These are the most important things without which humans cannot live. So, without food we cannot live, without clothes we cannot live, as well as without house we cannot live, because it is the fact that house gives us shelter and protection from different things, from climatic conditions, from rain, sunlight, cold, as well as it protects from different types of hazards that we face in our daily life, be it diseases, be it climate, or be it criminal activities. Now, houses, what are houses? What are houses? Any habitation, a building or habitation for humans are known as houses. So, what do we get from the knowledge? What do we get from this activity? Or what do we get from our lesson, that what impression about house can we make? Houses is not only a particular building, it can also be a shelter, an accommodation, may be permanent or may be temporary. So houses can be categorized into different types. The first one, what are the types of the houses? Like you can see here, I have already written, there are basically two to three types of houses. The one is kaccha house and the other one is pakka house. So you have to study what is kaccha house and what is pakka house. So, we have already studied about houses, now we are going to study about the types of houses. What are the types of houses, kaccha and pakka? What is kaccha house? Like I have already written here, that houses that are made of mud or straws or wood or tin or something that is a permanent temporary settlement is also known as kaccha house. So you can see here that what are the different categories. When you go to the village and you might have seen, or even some of the places nearby a house you might have seen, that there are some of the temporary settlements, or there are some of the houses which are not permanently made, which are not made of a brick, which cannot be easily broken, is known as kaccha house. Now you can see here what are the different materials required to make a kaccha house. There are wood, tin, then tiles and all. Even some of the houses may be made from bricks or cements, but they are not properly made. They can be easily be broken, or some hazards or natural disaster can easily destruct them. So, but there is one advantage of kaccha houses, that it is very easy for people to make. It is accessible to almost all different sections of society, be it irrespective of their financial situations. Now, then again there is this thing, you can see here, where are these kind of houses found? These kinds of houses are found in places, suburban places. Maybe it can be found in some cities, maybe it can be found in towns or maybe villages. But the main benefit of these kind of houses is that they are smallly accumulated, they are scattered everywhere. It is not permanent, it is temporary, it is destructible, but due to this, many people may be losing. Now you can see in hazardous disasters, like people can see natural disasters happening, flood, landslide, these kinds of houses are easily destructible. So people face lots of removing from their houses. Now you can see here there is pakka house. What is pakka house? What do you understand by pakka house? Houses that are made up of brick, cements are known as pakka house. It can be made of wood also, it can be made of bricks and cement, but generally these have the structure of concreteness that cannot be easily be broken. Okay, now the second one we come to pakka house. What are pakka houses? Pakka houses are the houses that are made from bricks and cements and concrete. They need sand, gravel and stones to be constructed. So now what we get from this knowledge of pakka house, that people have to invest a little more from the one they have invested in kaccha house. They have to make it, in order to make it a permanent settlement. This kind of settlement is a permanent settlement, and in this kind of settlement These are generally found in cities, towns and villages. So when we talk about cities, towns and villages, even in cities, some kacha house might be found. Like you can see jhuggis and jhopris. So that comes under kacha house. Now what we are going to study is pakka house. Like for example, the house or the building that I am standing, or maybe the building that you are lucky enough to be have been living. So that is kind of pakka house. If you see the construction of the building, if you see the construction of your particular building, that kind of house, you can see it is made up of cement, it is painted and different, so on. So when we are living in a pakka house, it gives different safety as well as safeguards of our house. It protects us from rains and different animals or stuff. It also protects from different hazardous activities and all. So this is why house is very much important. Now what we are going to study is that there are materials, there are certain materials required to make houses. What are the kind of materials that we require to make houses? You can see here bricks, cements, sands, stones, woods, iron, then tin, etc. This is required to make a pakka house, to make in order to make a complete concrete house, so that it is not easily destructible as well as it is not easily breakable. Now what are the things that are different kind of what are the things that is required to make a kacha house? You can see that there are straw, then there are wood. You can see, you might have seen a tin house, or maybe there are different, maybe some, you might have been seeing that some people who are very poor, who do not have a house, they might have been living in some camps which are made up of plastic tents, or even you can see in this picture people go, this kind of settlement is a temporary settlement. Now again, coming to the point, now there are two different types of settlement. One is permanent settlement, what is temporary settlement. Now somewhere or the other, we can also relate kacha house as temporary settlement, but not exactly we can, because of under kacha house people make hard jhuggis and jhopris that can easily be destructible, whereas pakka house is easily not destructible. So here comes the different types of settlement. Now we are going to study the different types of houses. What are the different types of houses? The different types of houses you can see in your book. You can see there are tin houses, straw houses, tilted houses, wooden houses. According to the area, it is not that everywhere people have pakka houses. Different types of houses depend upon different areas. What climatic condition is there? Some climate it's very hot and extreme, some climate it is very cool, and in some places it may be a plain land, whereas some places it may be high hilly at altitude. So there are different types of houses according to where people stay. Now there are still houses, straw houses, tilted houses, wooden houses. Now what are still houses? What are straw houses? What are tilted roof houses? What are wooden houses? Still houses are made according to the climatic factors that impacts their settlements. Some of the houses with bamboo poles are dug and it is inserted inside the ground, and then on top of that houses are made. Now the second house you can see is there. There are some straw houses. What are straw houses? Houses that are made up of straw or they have straw roofs are called as straw houses. Some of the places like Rajasthan and all, they have straw houses. And why? Because this Rajasthan, like you know, that receive less rainfall and it is very dry and hot. It is a desert place in Rajasthan. It's very extremely hot. And so why rural areas have thick walls, they have very thick mud walls which is covered with straw roof, like you can see it over here. So this one you can see, these are thick walls. These houses are made with thick walls and covered with straw roofs, and then which scientifically or somehow it makes the house cool. That's why people prefer to live in straw houses. Then the third one is that tilted roof houses. What are tilted roof houses? These tilted roof houses can also be made with wooden houses. Some of the houses in, if you see in hilly regions where they are. Okay, the final kind of houses, there are two tilted roof house and wooden houses. What are tilted roof houses? Tilted roof houses are found in the places where there are heavy snowfall or heavy, extremely hilly places where snowfall persists. Now, this kind of houses, this kind of roofs helps the houses, helps the snow to slide down easily so that the snow does not accumulate, and that is why this tilted houses are made like this kind of houses, tilted houses. Okay, now wooden houses, what are different, what are the last, what is the wooden house type is that some of the houses which is made up of wood, in some of the places like Himachal and all, there are some wooden floorings are done so that it helps to makes, it is also a scientific fact that the wooden houses are generally made warm and so on. Now then, in some places like coastal areas, there are ventilated, highly ventilated houses because it helps to make the house cool, as well as the big doors, as well as windows, the big windows. You can see that in the coastal areas that houses are made accordingly, the climatic factors, suiting the climatic factors, because some of in coastal areas, the houses, the areas are very humid. So houses are made with having many doors and windows so that it makes the whole house cool as well as airy. It has a big ventilation, as well as it has tilted or sloping roofs, like you can see here, with lots of pillars to support them. In some of the places like Kerala and all, you can find these kinds of houses. Now continuing with this chapter, I hope you should also understand that there are so many people who help to make construction of houses, like plumbers,